You too busy worry about sleeping alone, so you keep him around and you know how he roll. Maybe you too grown for the drama, wanna to be his girlfriend, but you ended up his mama. I'm not trying to create any problems.
Today I'm going to be talking about what you should do when your man cheats on you. We all have these conversations. Girl, you should fucking like leave a girl. Like, fuck that bitch up. It's a whole lot of things that people recommend that you do. Take my advice, but these are the things that I've been through and I would like to share with you. Number one, you're going to feel like shit after it happens. Oh my gosh, I can't believe he did this to me. Like, why would he just cheat on me? It's hard to get over. I understand that. One of the things that you should do is just get time to yourself. Number one mistake that females make is forgiving him too fast. Please, please, I'm so sorry. No. Give yourself time to think about it. What do I want to do? What's best for me? I know you're going to feel sorry for him, and you're also going to want to kill him at the same. Girls try to work it out immediately, and you're still not over it. Oh, I forgive you, and then you just go right back to the situation. Like, you'll be sleeping at night, and you'll be like having a dream about that bitch, and you'll be like, I fucking hate you, but you forgave him, so you can't go back and forth. I forgive you, but I hate you. You need a lot of time to yourself. Oh, so what the fuck am I gonna do when I'm horny? No, fuck it. Then you're gonna get caught up in your feelings and you're gonna be mad fucking. If mad fucking is a word. Rule number two, petty phase. Okay? I call it the petty phase because a lot of the times when people get cheated on, the first thing they wanna do is what? Be petty. There's nothing wrong with being a little bit petty, but don't go too extreme. You know how Amber Rose was all up on Chris Brown, like twerking on him and stuff? That's too extra. Don't do that. You'll end up losing who you are, and you might end up looking like a hoe. Don't let that nigga change who you are. You'll be the same person you were before. Rule number three, when you go through that petty phase, I feel like the petty phase should last for about maybe like a week or so. Don't be too like turned up. Go out with your girls, drink with your girls, talk shit about him and all that stuff. That's cool and all. Don't drag it out. Don't think about what the fuck he's doing or blah, 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 blah. Don't do that. When am I gonna get over him? I hate him. I don't wanna talk to him anymore. Why do I love him? Why do I still love him? Thinking about him and like still caring about him and still caring about what he does. Okay. And you can't fall out of love in one day. You're still gonna love him, but you're also gonna hate him. You're never gonna know overnight whether or not you still want to be with him. It's so easy to fall in love, but it is so hard to fall out of it, you know? Your heart is very strong because you guys created a bond together. And rule number four, I forgot the rule numbers, whatever. The first nigga who walks up to you and tries to give you play, don't be so quick to get in another relationship. Don't distract yourself with niggas. Because when you try to get in another relationship to try to get over the next dude, or when you try to fuck other dudes to get over your man or your previous, that's when you start losing like sight of yourself. They're just looking to fuck. Like no dudes are really like really, really trying to look out for your best interest. An environment like the club, pop the comment on your Instagram, leave that alone. Don't mess with dudes who are just like there immediately after your relationship. Like, don't try to mess with these rebounding. Rebound people or whatever, they do not work. They make you feel better temporarily, but essentially, your feelings as a whole and who you are, you will not get over that shit. That you will not get over that past relationship. Like, it'll make you feel better temporarily, but it will not fix you. Like, don't like really get in a serious relationship with the rebound nigga. Don't be thinking like, oh, the next nigga's gonna save your feelings. Cause it's not, like, it's not. You know who you love. You love who you love. And the dude that you're gonna be fucking around with, he's just gonna be like, yeah, she giving me some play. What is making you and your nigga look stupid? Time is very important. Timing is very important. Decide to get back in that relationship, there's no going back. fight. We're going to stick this out. We're going to stick it through. We're going to do this. We're going to work together. We're going to, who is this? I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. I mean, you should be able to trust each other enough to look in each other's phone. But what I'm saying is, don't start arguments over the past. The past in the past, in the present in the present. If that man is doing whatever it takes to prove to you, to show you that he loves you, and he wants to be with you, and he's, you know, ducking these bitches, then give him the benefit of the doubt. Another thing, if the person that he cheated on you, you personally know them, and or they were your friend or something like that, confront her. I'm not gonna tell you what to do, but you probably already got in the back of your mind, like, what to do. Ain't condoning violence. No shade, no shade. She didn't know about the relationship. Leave her alone. Unless you catch them in action. It don't matter, because you lost your damn mind by then, so you gonna do what you want. When will that pain go away? Is that pain ever gonna stop? Might get over the pain, but you will never forget. You just won't ever forget what happened. All you can do is overcome it and try to get over it and try to build a new chapter. If that doesn't work for you, then maybe that person's not the best for you. Now, I'm just speaking for myself, and I'm just trying to give you girls a little bit of advice on what to do. You can go for guys as well. Don't jump too fast and back into a relationship, because your mind is like, don't get back into that relationship unless you know you're ready, okay? And if you guys have any questions or anything you want to ask me, please feel free to send me any messages or put something down in my little, you know, comment section down here. And thank you guys for watching.
But don't call me when he's done messing up. Girl, don't play with my head. Talk about it's over for real this time. Just shut up and come lay down in this bed.